Hi everybody, Dr. Kazi over here at Kazi Cosmetic Clinic in Irvine, California. And today I'm doing Restylane Kiss for this patient for her lips. She's got really nice thin lips, good shape, but she just wanted a little bit more definition, a little bit more hydration. So Kiss is a very good product for that because we could actually give a nice border for the very nice, crisp, beautiful border, hydrate the lips, but without over plumping it or causing it to look a little too unnatural. So what I'm doing right here is I'm creating these pillars to help support the lip and pull upwards. So we have multiple ways of doing some numbing for patients. A lot of times for first timers, we do topical numbing if needed. We could also do nerve blocks as well. So I'm just kind of going really subtle right now, really soft and subtle. The idea is just to kind of give a little bit of hydration and make this border pop without making it look unnatural though. Do it again. So just because it's bleeding doesn't mean there's pain. The lip is just a vascular area. So just hold pressure there for a second. And that way we can make sure you don't get too many bruises too when we hold on pressure constantly. So interestingly enough, this is getting more and more popular even with masks on because people are realizing that you still want to look good, feel good, just about yourself, really. I'm just pulling this up here. That's what I'm doing here. Just marching along to pull up this upper lip and just put pressure there again.
Is it painful?
So we actually do two forms of numbing, typically for patients with any, especially if it's the first time. We actually do a topical numbing with a very strong anesthetic, and then I do injectable numbing for some nerve blocks as well.
And how long do fillers last?
So it depends on your own body's metabolism, but mostly they last about 1 year based on their own clinical studies. So you can see how this one's already pulling upwards and getting a little bit definition on the left side there. And that's what we like to see. That jolted you there. So the Cupid's bow is probably the most sensitive part of the lip. And again, there's multiple different ways of doing numbing if we need to. I always inject more lidocaine, although there's lidocaine in here. So this is easily the most sensitive part right here. And this is her first time. So you could see kind of what to expect if you already have some thin lips. just in terms of how to define this and what the process would look like. So I'm using Wrestling Kiss. It's one of the newer products that are in America, although it's been around in Europe for a while. I like it a lot for thin lips. It does swell up a little bit more than some of the other products, but it's nice because it's really soft, very subtle, but still actually gives definition. So that's actually very nice for the lips because you could get this done without overdoing it. And if you see over here, she has this area where it's kind of hollow right over here. So we just have to give a little bit more support for that. So what I do is actually I create a little cross hatching. To support that. But you can start to see it take shape right now. And then we're going to also try to make some definition and some borders for the lower lip, of course. Surprisingly, the lower lip could be actually a little bit more challenging than top lip. A lot of times people don't realize this, but you have to be aware of the patient's natural lip shape for the lower lip and really go along that, because it can look very lumpy and bumpy if you don't do that. Excuse me, let's pull this up here. Yeah. So this is hyaluronic acid, so it's a very safe product. It's a sugar product that's actually naturally in your body. However, if it goes into a vessel, then it could cause what's called an occlusion, and it has been reported, usually in other areas of the body, but it can certainly happen in the lips. It's very vascular, and if it does happen, you have to reverse it. So fortunately, I'm always well stocked in the reversal agent. Knock on wood, it hasn't happened yet for me, but it is a possibility always whenever you're injecting. So you just have to be aware of that. And aware of the natural anatomy of the person. So whenever I take a look at patients during the initial consultation, I take a look and see kind of where their arteries would probably go. Sometimes if you look really close enough, you can actually see an artery palpating, just pulsating, I should say. So obviously you're going to want to avoid that area. So again, this is really just more of a subtle type of lip filler. And especially this time, what we're doing is really subtle. Usually what I do recommend is coming back again in a few weeks, and then we go in and put a little bit more volume in there. I really don't believe in overfilling or doing too much volume, especially that initial session.
How often do you recommend getting fillers?
So it depends on what your goals are, you know, what your aesthetic goal is. Obviously, some people want to have it so that they're always at the same level, no matter what. In that case, I recommend coming a little more frequently, you know, maybe 8 months, 6 months. It just depends on how your body metabolizes the filler. So again, I'm trying to fix there's this area of hollowness that's right over here, if you see that right here. So I'm trying to give a little bit more support. And then a lot of times what I do is actually I combine this with Botox for a little lip filler, lip flip, I should say. So that pulls up the muscle a little bit nicer too. And that way you don't have to overfill this area. Thin lips are very difficult to do correctly, but you can do them, and you should do them, actually, in a certain way. So we're getting there. It's coming together now. Is still supporting that area where I was saying that there's a little bit of hollowness that was up in this upper top lip. Still want to help correct that divot as much as I can. Obviously, there's only so much you could do with filler, and you don't want to overfill areas. But by putting some support there, we could actually help pull up the area as well. So what I'm doing right now is actually, there's some little lines over there, so I'm actually trying to break up those lines and filling it up so that it looks a little bit more hydrated.
Someone's asking which procedure you're doing right now.
So this is lip filler. This is with Restylane Kiss. This is a hyaluronic acid filler. We're doing this on a patient with thin lips. She just wanted to get a little bit more definition, a little bit more fullness, look a little bit more hydrated. And so that's what we're trying to achieve here. It's going to be subtle. This is not something, you know, that I'm doing for someone that wants really large lips in this technique. This is just going to be something that she wants just a little bit more definition here. There's multiple different fillers. I carry all of them, all the FDA approved ones. It just depends on what your body needs, what your natural anatomy needs, and what your aesthetic goals are. So see these little columns? She actually has really nice natural filtering columns. So what I'm gonna do is actually just give a little bit of support there, and that makes that Cupid's bow area pop up even a little bit more. This can pinch just a little bit. Yeah. That's really nice because it makes it really more defined there. A little pressure right there. So you can see as it's all coming together here. For those of us that are just joining us, she had very thin lips. And we'll show what she had before and for the after right now, coming up very soon. Just going to march along just a little bit, just feel like fix a couple more hollow spots. But otherwise, we're actually pretty much done already. Thank you, everybody. Dr. Kazi over here at Kazi Cosmetic Clinic. Thanks for joining us.